This problem, we have two reactions, gas phase, irreversible. The first one's first order in reactant A, and the second one is second order. And we want to compare it to the same conversion where we want to have higher selectivity to the product B. And the question is, if we carry out this in a constant volume batch reactor, or we carry it out in a piston and cylinder arrangement at constant pressure. So the piston would move up as reaction proceeds because this reaction increases the number of moles. Which one will give us the higher selectivity towards B? We're keeping the temperature constant. We start out the same conditions. And so to favor B, to have selectivity towards B, we want low concentration of A. The lower the concentration of A, the higher the selectivity, because the relative rates that we form B over the rates that we form C are going to be related to the rate constant for the first reaction, and then to rate constant second reaction, CA squared. So this is instantaneous selectivity. Higher concentration is going to give us lower selectivity. In the constant pressure system, as the number of moles increase, the piston will move up, the volume will decrease. So increasing the number of moles also causes the concentration of A to decrease. In addition, of course, to reaction causing the concentration of A to decrease. And thus, if we want to have the highest selectivity, we would pick the constant pressure batch reactor. This is the example on chemical equilibrium where we have a container, piston and cylinder arrangement, constant pressure, where we have some solid, calcium oxide in one phase, calcium carbonate in the second phase, and then CO2 and nitrogen in the gas phase, and we're at equilibrium. And what we're going to do is remove some volume, not selective, so the volume has the same mole fractions as the original gas phase. If we remove 25% of the gas phase this way, keeping an isothermal, carrying out in this piston and cylinder arrangement, what happens to the solid phases? And the answer is that nothing happens. We've decreased the volume. We have not changed the partial pressure of CO2. The partial pressure of nitrogen stays the same. Their amount decreases. And so at equilibrium, the equilibrium constant for the reaction of calcium carbonate decomposing is just the pressure of CO2 divided by the pressure of CO2 at standard conditions, which is 1 bar. So it's the pressure of CO2 over 1 bar. Equilibrium constant is not changed. Therefore, the partial pressure is not changed. And therefore, we see no change in the solid phases. In this problem, we have a semi-batch reactor with a zero-order reaction. And we initially start with the reactor one-third full of reactant. And then we're going to add additional reactant to the system. We're going to keep adding until we fill up the reactor. And then we let reaction be carried out to completion. And what we want to know is, how does the total rate of product formation, not the rate per volume, but the total rate, moles per hour, change as a function of time? And then what's the reason for this behavior? So we're going to plot the total rate of product formation versus time. And for a zero order reaction, let's call this the rate that B forms. Well, it's the rate constant times the volume in the reactor. It doesn't depend on concentration. It depends on how much we have available to react, since the rate constant is per volume. And so Initially, that means we have some rate. As we increase the amount in the container, we're adding in a constant feed rate, so the volume's increasing at a linear rate, which means the rate would increase until we have three times the rate, because we have now the tank full, and it was one-third full. And now we stop adding, but reaction proceeds, and reaction's not dependent on concentration, so the reaction's going to be this constant rate, and it's going to be at that constant rate until we use up what's in the system. Since we don't know the volume of the reactor, the rate constant, we don't know the time, but after some time, if it stayed zero order until everything was used up, then of course the rate would drop to zero and there'd be no more reaction. In reality, a zero order reaction at low concentration reactant is going to become first order typically. And so that means at some point where we get to relatively low concentration, we would see some exponential decrease in concentration and exponential decrease in rate as a function of time. I'm not going to be able to draw that very clearly, but the idea is the rate approaches zero at longer times.